Tim Walz has formally accepted the Democratic vice presidential nomination. In his speech at the Democratic National Convention in Chicago, the Minnesota governor said he and Kamala Harris will cut taxes for the middle class and make buying homes more affordable. Harris will formally accept the party's presidential nomination later this week. Meanwhile, Democrats turned the tables and took digs at Republican presidential nominee Donald Trump's aide. Former U.S. President Bill Clinton took to the stage at the national convention and compared his aide to Trump's. Georgia's former lieutenant governor and a Republican, Geoff Duncan, also made a case for the Harris-Walz ticket.
I am a Republican. But tonight, I stand here as an American. I realize Trump was a direct threat to democracy, and his actions disqualified him from ever stepping foot into the Oval Office again.
Now let's cut to the chase. I am too old to gild the lily. 2 days ago, I turned 78, the oldest man in my family for four generations. And the only personal vanity I want to assert is I'm still younger than Donald Trump.
The arrest of two companions of dismissed Mayor Alice Guo in Indonesia. Our very own Willard Chang on the line now with details. Willard, what can you tell us?
Hi, Casey. DILG Secretary Benner Abalo said two companions of dismissed Mayor Alice Guo are now detained in Indonesia. This is based on information he received last night from PNP Chief Romel Marbil. The matter is being coordinated by the Philippine Police Atas in Indonesia, showing he said how Philippine authorities are taking the matter seriously. No further details were given, including the circumstances of their detention. But in a separate interview with Justice Reporters, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla confirmed that the names of the detained companions of Guo are Sheila Guo, identified as Alice Guo's sister, and Cassandra Leong. Remulla said that this proves the connection between illegal POGO operations in Bambantaylak and Porac, Pampanga. Ong is the representative of a company that provides services to POGOs like Lucky South 99. Remulla said both will be sent back to the Philippines because of their alleged use of fake passports. In a separate hearing of the House Squad Committee also this morning, House Committee on Public Order and Safety Chairperson Dan Fernandez also identified Cassandra Leong as one of those now in the custody of Indonesian authorities. Meanwhile, Abalo said Kingdom of Jesus Christ Pastor Apollo Kiboloy is still in the Philippines based on information he has received, adding that authorities are doing everything to look for him. Back to you, Casey.
Okay, Willard, just a couple of questions for you before we let you go. Yes, they are in the custody of Indonesian authorities, but what passports do they carry?
We assume, Carmina, that based on previous information also released by Senator Risa Ontiveros, the passport that Alice Guo herself used was Philippine passport that she was carrying, according to authorities, was fraudulently obtained.
Yeah, but what about Sheila Guo and Cassandra Ong?
We have no information on that yet, Carmina.
Because the next step is we're assuming that they're going to be extradited here, but what would be the legal legs that Philippine authorities are standing on if these two are carrying foreign passports?
We are aware that both Sheila Guo and Cassandra Leong have Philippine passports, and based on the information or the statement of Justice Secretary Remulla, we can conclude that for Sheila Guo, she used her Philippine passport, and that because of that, she would be sent back to the Philippines, Carmina.
And what of Cassandra Ong?
On Ong specifically, Remulla also said that both of them will be deported back to the Philippines.
All right, thanks.
Assuming they used their Philippine passports, Carmina.
All right, thanks a lot. Willard Chang there joining us on the line. Thanks, Willard. Take care. Former President Rodrigo Duterte linked to the killing of three Chinese drug lords in a Davao jail back in 2016. Inmates Andy Magdadaro and Leopoldo Tan told the House Quad Committee it was the government that ordered the killing of the three victims in exchange for money and their freedom.
Dumalaw sa akin ang kaibigan ko na si SPO4 Arthur Narasulis. Nakiusap sa akin si SPO4 Arthur Narasulis at sinabi niya na may ipatatrabaho ako sa iyo at may basbas sa taas. Baka matulungan ka rin namin na makalaya. Kakausapin ko namin ang presidente. Sabi pa ni SPO4 Arthur Narasulis, sayang din itong isang manok kada ulo sa aking pagkakaintindi at pagkakaalam. Ang isang manok ay 1,000,000.
Nilapitan po ako ni Leopoldo Tan ng kasama kong piso sa maximum security compound. Sinabihan niya po ako na tulungan ko daw siya at may ipapatira. Magbibigay daw sila ng kaunting halaga. Tinanong ko siya kung sino ang mga ipapatumba. Sinabi niya na tatlong Chinese na nasa foreign ward area ng Davao Prison and Penal Farm. Dinagdag pa ni Leopoldo Tan na kami ay nasa panig na ng gobyerno sa mga oras na yon. At pinangakuan kami ng kalayaan maliban sa kaunting halaga.
Tan claims former President Duterte personally congratulated jail officials for the deaths of the Chinese inmates. The two witnesses said they agreed to testify because of their anger towards the Duterte administration, which they said failed to fulfill its promise to them.
Habang naglalakad kami papuntang investigation section, tumunog ang cellphone ni Superintendent Padilla. Nakita ko sa napilindot ni Superintendent Padilla ang kanyang cellphone. Nadinig ko na sinabi nung tumawag kay Superintendent Padilla, "Congrats, Superintendent Padilla. Job well done. Pero grabe yung ginawa, dinuguan." Alam ko na ang kausap ni Superintendent Padilla ay si President Duterte dahil pamilyar ko ang boses niya.
Nakakausap mo ba si President Duterte?
Narinig ko lang palagi yung boses niya, kaya pamilyar yung boses na narinig ko. Pagkatapos ng tawag, sabi ni Superintendent Padilla sa mga kasamahan niya doon, tumawag si Presidente na congrats sa akin. Dahil sa sinabing ito ni Superintendent Padilla, kaya lalo akong napaniwala na ang tumawag sa kanya ay si Presidente Duterte.